You should look at your reflection if you wanna see a light. You're heading in the right direction if you wanna pick a side. Give me more perfection if you wanna see me cry. If you wanna love somebody, if you wanna love somebody, I'm your guy. I'm your guy. You should get your car started if you wanna be a part. Go to the Californian party if you wanna fuck a star. Or flick back through your memories if you want a broken heart. Or if you wanna love somebody. Or if you wanna love somebody. Pretend. You gotta make your kiss a little colder if it's ever gonna end. Lay your head upon my shoulder if you just need a friend. Or if you wanna love somebody.
I see friends shaking hands, saying how is grown. I watch them grow. They learn much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Ooh, yeah. Let's get drunk. I'll pour my heart out to my mouth. This year's been hard for us, no doubt. Let's raise a glass to a better one. Let all the things that we've overcome ring out to us, cause me and you, we can hold this up. And only you understand how I'm feeling now, yeah. And I know that I can tell you when and then. You won't judge, you're just listening, yeah. Cause you're the best thing that ever happened to me. Cause my darling, you and I can take over the world. One step at a time, just you and I. Cause you're the only one who brings light just like the sun. One step at a time, just you and I.
Let's get drunk and reminisce about the days when we were broke, not getting paid, and taking trips at the weekend. When I would drop down to see you, and we would paint the tower. Too many shots, I'll be passing out. Cause I can never keep up. Quad bots, now I'm puking up. And I know I can tell you anything. Yeah, you won't judge, you're just listening. Cause you are the best thing that ever happened to me. Darling, you and I can take over the world. One step at a time, just you and I. Cause you're the only one who brings light just like the sun. One step at a time, just you and I, yeah.
I'm tired of chasing paper, staring at the screen. Saving up for weeks now, just to get to you, my dear.
I know you're far from my home. This ain't a weekend bar. And know my heart grows fonder. Must be city love.
It's my darling, you and I can take over the world. One step at a time, just you and I. It's my darling, you and I. Time, just you and I. Cause you're the only one who brings light just like the sun. One step at a time, just you and I.
You and I.
Yeah, one step at a time, just you and I.
Yeah, one step at a time, just you and I.
So, Jim and Trish, thank you for letting me marry your beautiful daughter and accepting me into your family. You've always made me feel really welcome. When I moved in 10 years ago and you didn't notice.
Oh, it did.
It was good. I got a draw, like, a couple of years ago, so it's all right. So, when I came to ask you if I could marry Emma, I, like, sat in the pub car park for ages over the road. I went in and they were like, why is Chris here? Emma's not here. So then I sat down. Trish was watching Neighbours. So I was like, oh, shit, what am I going to do? But she did. She's, wait, that's in the speech. Don't ruin it. So anyway, Trish stopped watching Neighbours, so I knew they were going to say yes. She, like, squealed like a girl. Jim cried. Take her. You guys accepted, and the rest is history. I was obviously really nervous. Emma, your only daughter, you'd expect like a really handsome, kind, generous mannered come and take her away. Yay! We are a rare breed though, aren't we, Jim? So you are really welcome. No, but in all honesty, I couldn't really ask for better in-laws. I did ask Emma if I could ask, but she said I wasn't allowed, so. just joking. I just hope I can repay the kindness you've both shown me by making Emma really happy. You don't get a toast, though.
Thank you.
So finally, I want to talk about my beautiful bride, Emma. So, we've been together for 13 years this year. She steadily groomed me since I was 17. She said I was doing a good job and said thank you. I know most people think 13 is a bit of an unlucky number, but it's become a bit of a good luck charm to us, so it seemed only fitting that we got married in our 13th year. We've had a pretty hard road and we've had our ups and downs, but we've also always had our amazing friends and family around us to get us through and our constant friendship for each other. So I first laid eyes on Emma at my Argos interview in 2005, which Sandra got for me, so that was good. So it's Sandra's fault. Then Beth. I walked in and she was sat on the counter. And I'd obviously rocked up on my moped, thanks to my Uncle Mel. My rock pots and my little beard, I thought I was cool. Nobody else did. Yeah. You can say that now, it's gone. So she was sat there on the counter and I thought, that's the most beautiful person I've ever seen in my entire life. And I went home and I said, Jim, is this Fitbird at work? I said, don't worry, son, I've got some chat plans for you. I didn't use any of them. It was something about sweating and being a fat lass, but I don't know. So anyway, I thought, you know what? My natural charisma is not going to work on this one. She's a little bit older and she's not thick. So I devised a bit of a plan with a bit of help from Dean. I said, here, are you at work? No. Texted Emma's number. So he sent his Emma's number. I've left me CDs at work. Can you just put them to one side? She texted back, yeah, no worries. And then obviously she thought, oh, he's all right, him, I'll text him. So I worked on her a bit and then we went out around town a couple of times. And the night I thought, yeah, this is it, gonna make me moves. We got really drunk and we were walking back to the taxi rank and I was like walking backwards. Boom, straight into a lamppost. Gutted. But my dad said, if you make a woman laugh, you're halfway there. And it obviously worked and the rest is history. And obviously I courted her for a little while and took her to Morrison's Cafe. I didn't pay, but I still took her. And then we went to the New Inn and had a couple of drinks and Judy beat me at pool and made me look like less of a man. But it's all right, I let her win, because she's a woman. But some people spend their whole lives looking for someone that makes them the better version of themselves. And you do that to me. I was just lucky to find you when I was young. And not in prison, and mum and dad were pretty happy. We've tackled some pretty hard things, and it's been an amazing adventure, and I can't wait to see where this next chapter takes us. You inspire me to be a better person, and I promise that I'll always be in the way. I'll always make you repeat yourself, but I will get stuff in the zone. I'll never speak to you before 10 o'clock or if you've had a coffee, and I won't ever steal the best part of your muffin. That was a big mistake. We have had our ups and downs. Again, Eleanor stole a bit of my speech, but we did almost split up in 2011 when we decided to share a fruit crumble. And she doesn't like Game of Thrones, but you know, it's all right. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you could all be upstanding to raise a toast to my beautiful bride and the new Mrs. Kersov.
Welcome to the family.
tell me that you want me, and I'll be yours completely, for better or for worse. I know we'll have our disagreements, be fighting for no reason. I wouldn't change it for the world. 'Cause I knew the first day that I met you, I was never gonna let you slip away. And I still remember feeling nervous, trying to find the words to get you here today.